Janet Leigh.
And here's our star, Rosemary Clooney.
I'll never be the same. I haven't got a worry to my name. There are some who study nights to be a mourner. Me, I have a new adventure round each corner. Fly the flags, ring the bell. What a future my fortune tells. Feel so free, I'll never be the same. I haven't got a worry. Who's got time to worry? Haven't got a worry to my name.
You know, it bothers me to have someone looking over my shoulder. I'm awfully glad you could join us this evening because, in addition to our usual group, we're going to have a visit from a very special friend of mine, Miss Janet Leigh.
Janet Leigh? The glamorous motion picture star? The wife of Tony Curtis?
The very same, Nels. But Janie's more than that. For one thing, she's just about the most well-organized person I know. And, you know, that kind of impresses me because I'm inclined to be a little bit on the scatterbrain side with things like remembering appointments.
Or where you parked your car.
Yeah, little things like that. But not Janie. She writes everything down in a running diary she carries around with her. She even started me doing it, Nelson. You know, it's not a bad idea. You ought to try it sometime.
Maybe so.
Yeah. The only trouble with it is the fact that I can never remember where I left my diary.
Well, every system has its flaws.
That's true. But I know you're going to enjoy meeting Janie. And I'm sure you'll be interested in these words from our host, too.
There is no...
I told you my friend Janet Leigh was going to be here, and as you can see, she already is. Janie, how come you didn't wait for me to give you an introduction? But Rosie, this is the exact time I... And you know how I am. I sure do. Punctual. That's the trouble with Janet. You know, it looks like we could get something a little more comfortable for you to sit in than this.
Oh, I don't mind this. I'm used to sets. Anyway, I sat on much more uncomfortable things when I was in Africa making a picture called Safari. I almost sat on a crocodile.
Really?
Yeah.
Imagine. A little girl from Stockton, California, all the way over in Africa.
Oh, well, it's really nothing at all. I seem to recall catching the pride of Maysville, Kentucky at the Palladium in London, England.
Mm.
I guess we both move around pretty good, huh?
Isn't it wonderful that we can enjoy this so while we're young?
While we're young? Oh, Rosella, that's a pretty sneaky way to get into a song cue.
Effective, though.
You're right. Look, you go sing, I'll go change, and I'll meet you back here in exactly 9 minutes and 23 seconds. Okay?
She'll be here, too.
Let's see. 9 minutes, 23 seconds, right here.
Songs were made to sing while we're young. We're young.
Looking for a fresh...
Hi, fellas.
Hi, Rosie.
Welcome to the low rent district.
It's not exactly Bel Air, is it? But it fits our next song. You have to admit that.
Oh, we do. We admit the heck out of it.
You see, a couple of seasons back, I had the good fortune to record a wonderful piece of material of Stuart Hamblin's. You remember this old house?
Remember it? We lived in it when we first got together.
Well, anyway, just as soon as you fellas can get back into that aging domicile and Nelson Riddle can rustle up a little music for us, we'll be all set to go, right?
We are already gone.
Go!
This old house once knew his children. This old house once knew his wife. This old house was home and comfort as they fought the storms of life. This old house once rang with laughter. This old house heard many shouts. Now it trembles in the darkness when the lightning walks about.
Ain't gonna need this house no longer. Ain't I gonna need this house no more.
Ain't got time to fix the shingles. Ain't got time to fix the floor. Ain't got time to oil the hinges nor to mend the window pane.
Ain't gonna need this house no longer. Need to get ready to meet the saints.
This old house is getting shaky. This old house is getting old. This old house lets in the rain. This old house lets in the cold. Oh, his knees are getting chilly, but he feels no fear of pain, 'cause he sees an angel peeking through a broken window pane.
Ain't gonna need this house no longer. Ain't gonna need this house no more.
Ain't got time
to fix the shingles. Ain't got time to fix the floor.
Ain't got time to oil the hinges nor to mend the window pane.
Ain't gonna need this house no longer. Needs to get ready to meet the saints.
This old house is afraid of thunder. This old house is afraid of storms. This old house just groans and grumbles when the night wind flings it down. This old house is a-getting feeble. This old house is a-needing paint. Just like him, it's tuckered out, but he's a-getting ready to meet the saints. Ain't gonna need this house no longer. Ain't a-gonna need this house no more. Ain't got time to fix the shingles. Ain't got time to fix the floor.
Ain't got time.
Ready to meet the same.
How about this? I give you a big build-up on that paragon of punctuality, Janet Leigh, and she's not even here. Hey, Rosie.
Hey, yourself.
Yeah. You said to meet you right here, not over there.
I never seem to win at one of these things. Well, look at you.
Oh, I thought I'd slip into something comfortable.
Yes. You know, aside from being neighbors and great friends, Janet and I have another great big mutual interest.
Yes, we're BFWs, best friends' wives.
You see, when the Ferrers and the Curtises get together, Janet and I usually wind up on the sidelines watching Joe and Tony trying to outdo each other.
Oh, they're a regular two-man improvement association.
Mm.
Let's see now. Joe's got Tony reading Shakespeare.
Yeah. And Tony's got Joe going all out on physical fitness.
Oh, yeah. And then Joe is teaching Tony how to play chess.
That's just so he can beat him.
Naturally, what else? They're really a couple of kids.
I don't know. We're stuck with them, though.
Yeah, what are you going to do?
Men. You can't do anything with them.
No, and it wouldn't be too much fun without them.
A man, oh, a man, any woman will say, whatever he is, we like him that way. As strong as an ox or as meek as a pup, he's just a small boy who will never grow up. A leader by day, he can make business hum, then wind up at night under some woman's thumb. Uh-huh, 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 uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. A man, oh, a man, any woman will say, whatever he is, we like him that way.
Enjoyed it. I only hope Joe and Tony enjoyed it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, they were probably so wrapped up in the chess game they forgot to watch.
Sure.
Or is this the night that they paint?
I don't know. Let me check. Neither. They're fencing.
Oh, I forgot to lock up the good vase.
What are you worrying about? They're at my house.
Janet, so's my good vase.
Oh, I forgot. I didn't put it down in my book.
Your book.
Maybe I'd better phone.
Yeah, would you give me a chance to get over there for my next number?
Sure.
Good.
Bye. Now what do? I know. I'll set the scene for. Let's see. We're going to need something that goes with the blues. Something lonely and moody. The sort of place a girl who's just lost her fella might wander into late at night.
My mama done told me when I
I was in pigtails. My mama done told me, hun, a man's gonna sweetheart and give you the big eye. But when the sweet talking's done, a man is a two-faced, a worrisome thing who'll leave you to sing the blues in the night. Now the rains are falling, hear the train a-calling. In the night, the evening breeze will start the trees to crying, and the moon will hide its light. When you get the blues in the to Mobile, from Memphis to St. Joe, wherever the four winds blow. I've been in some big towns, heard me some big talk, but there is one thing I know. A man is a two-faced, sing the blues in the night. Ooh-wee. Ooh-wee. My mama was right, there's blues in the
Wait a minute. Where are you going, Gene?
The fellas are waiting for me over on the steps.
Well, what's the pipe for?
That's for Bob Strassen. He can't sing the next number without it.
Oh. What's the next number, Gene? I'm Forever Blowing Bubbles?
Oh, Rosie.
Oh, by the way.
Yes?
Janet Leigh said don't worry about your good vase. She forgot that she loaned it to Gracie Allen for a party.
Later. Well, that's a relief. I think. Anyway, as soon as Gene delivers Bob's pipe and gets his wind back, the Hilos are going to report on some pretty celestial doings that took place recently. Looks like they're all fired up and raring to go.
Your eyes held a tender light.
The way they sing.
Don't you, though?
Yeah.
Oh, listen, Janet, thank you for easing my mind about Gracie having my vase.
Oh, that's all right. Only she doesn't.
No?
No, she loaned it to a friend last week.
Who?
You.
Fine.
That's my Rosie.
Thank you so much for coming over. And listen, if Joe's still at your house playing with Tony, would you send him home for supper, please?
Well, right away, you
bet. Okay.
Bye.
Good night. Isn't she nice? You know, I suppose there are many ways of saying goodnight as there are people in the world. And I'm sure each one is effective in its own way. Right now, I'd like to show you one goodnight, which is very, very popular at our house.
Close your eyes, close your eyes. Go to sleep. While the night wind through the trees sings a lullaby for you, go to sleep, my dearest one. Sleep and dream now, my darling. For your sake, in my arms, in my arms, oh.
That just about does it for now. But before we go, I'd like to thank Nelson Riddle and the orchestra and the High-Lows for their usual high-grade contribution to the proceedings. Thanks again to Janet Leigh. And, of course, a special thanks to all of you for being with us, too. I hope you'll remember to be with us next time, because I think of you ever so tenderly.